Guys, Gabe here with GTS Construction. Today, I wanted to show you guys what we're using to put down this multi-width. We're using the Camo Drive. This is W here.
Hey there. Yeah.
He's gonna be showing you how we're putting this down with this tool. So the thing is it's an awesome tool, great invention, great idea. It's got a couple flaws. We're gonna run through it real quick, and then we'll show you again the breakdown of like what we think maybe could be improved on it. So check it out. This is how it works. So it's pretty fast. It's pretty simple. Basically, you just got to keep quite a bit of pressure on the handle, pushing it into the board, and let the screw do the work. Otherwise, the screw will actually push it off of the deck board, and then it'll go in all funky, or it might not even go into the deck board. Runs pretty smooth. We're making pretty good progress. If you guys are wondering why we have a bunch of speed squares in there, it's because a speed square is exactly 3/16 of an inch and it gives us a perfect gap. So that's just how we run the tool. It goes pretty smoothly. Hey dude, show them what we think could be better on the tool. Like, we just had a malfunction where the end just fell off.
Yeah, the end. So if you you just want to push on the shaft here, the handle. You want to put all your pressure on the handle, and not really very much pressure on the gun, because if you press too much on the gun, then like the bit will press too hard on the screw, it'll fuck up the screw.
I might have to bleep that out. We'll see. I might just roll with it. Anyway, so
if you press too hard on the handle, it'll press too hard on the screw, it'll jack up the screw. And it'll jam. So if it jams, I'll show you a jam. So it jammed. So all you do is rack it back, and then another one. So that screw popped out somewhere.
So you actually end up losing quite a few screws just because it'll jam. And then when it jams, it ends up spitting out like 3 screws at one time, and then it just goes crazy and you end up losing a bunch of screws if you're not careful. Yeah. And these clips, they're super nice, but they're pretty expensive. It's about 200, I believe. I got the box right here. Let's say it says approximately 285 square feet in a box, 1,000 screws, and it's not cheap. They run about $70 to $80 a box. So, I mean, it works, does great. But I definitely think the orange edge tip, it falls off sometimes if you're not careful. It actually just jam up and fall off. So that needs to be a little bit tighter. I feel like the tolerances could be tighter on that. The reload spring that pulls, let me show you guys. This spring here, it's kind of like just a coil spring. I don't know what you call that. It's like a measuring tape. I don't even know what you call that. But it just pulls the tape, the collated strip. It pulls the collated strip back with some tension. And this could be a little bit stronger because sometimes it doesn't actually feed the screws into there fully. And the screws just kind of jam up that way too. So anyway, great tool. And I mean, we're making pretty good progress, as you guys can see. I think we did this in about 2 days worth of work. So pretty good progress. Thanks to this guy.